Thank you.
Come on. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, hallelujah. 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 The Lord of God has done enough to show you. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! God, you've done too much for me not to give him a praise. I don't know about you, but I got to open up my mouth, even in my bad times. I got to open up my mouth, praise God. Even when I'm feeling bad and sick in my body, I got to open up my mouth because God has done too much for me. Hallelujah. Just to sit down and not open up my mouth to give him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As you heard, praise God, Pastor Robert said he has the vision. He has the vision. He has it. For folks to come in. For the question, praise God, before I get into this word is, are you ready? Are you spiritually prepared for when these people come in here? Can you do exactly what Sister Ruth Capri was talking about keeping your mouth shut? Are you ready to sacrifice yourself for what God has to do for this church? Are you willing to go the mile? Are you willing to go the distance, praise God? You go the distance with everything else in your life, but are you willing to go the distance with God? Are you willing? Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this time, dear God. We thank you for this opportunity to preach your word, Lord, as we get into your word, Father, Lord, that as I decrease, you increase, Father God. Lord, I want you to touch the heart and soul of your people this morning. In the name of Jesus, I want this word to transform someone. In the name of Jesus, I want the word to transform somebody's heart, mind, and soul, dear God. To be with you, dear God. Not to be with the enemy, dear God, but to be with you. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Amen, amen, amen. Last week I came, praise God, before you, a couple weeks ago, I'm sorry, came before you and I told you about the benefit of being saved, praise God. Part two of the benefits of being saved, praise God, who do you obey? Do y'all know who y'all obey? Do you obey God or do you obey the devil? Which one do you obey? For the Bible says you can only serve one master, so who do you serve unto death? We have so many different reports, praise God, of needing of finance and the needing of healing and the needing of this, that, and the other. Who do you serve in order to get what you need? For the Bible says that God supplies the needs according to his riches and glory. So what does the devil tell you that he's going to do for you if God's providing it? There's something wrong with the mentality of a person if they truly believe that Satan's going to provide something for them. There's something wrong with your mind if you believe just because you got some money in your pocket that you went somewhere. You have the wrong mentality, praise God, to think, praise God, just because you have the nicest clothes that you're going somewhere or the nicest house, praise God. That means nothing unto God. I don't know what's wrong with the thinking of some people just because you're able to do something better or different than someone else, praise God. Just because you have more than the other person doesn't mean that that person is less than a person. Hallelujah. And if you will, turn to the book of Romans, chapter 6. Romans chapter 6. We're going to be at verse 14. You got to say amen. Book of Romans chapter 6, verse 14. It says, for sin shall not have dominion over you. For ye are not under the law, but under grace. I'm going to read that again so you have an understanding of exactly where you're supposed to be at in Christ. It says, for sin shall not have dominion over you. I just want to stop right there before I continue on. We can have everything. You can allow everything to be over you. You can crawl up under a rock because you're scared. But the Bible said that sin shall not have dominion over you. It doesn't rule you. You rule it through the Holy Ghost. Sin shall not have a dominion over you. It shouldn't tell you to do wrong. It shouldn't have the ability or have take place in your life where it's overriding everything that God has already told you to do. Sin should have dominion over you. We have dominion over animals.
That's right.
We tell the animals what to do. If you tell a dog to come here, it comes here.
Right.
You tell that cat to get away or come here, it comes here. We have dominion over those animals.
Yes,
so we have dominion over sin. What do you tell sin? Get for away from me. The Bible said that Jesus told sin, told Satan, to get thee behind me, Satan. Get thee behind me. He had authority. See, you have to understand your authority in Christ. You have the power to tell the devil to get behind you.
All right.
I'm going to take my time just a little while. I'm not going to hold you long. But I want you to understand through the Holy Ghost exactly what this message means. Who do you serve? We have too much anointing and too much power for sin to have dominion over us. We have too much anointing and too much power to let sin control us. We have too much power through the Holy Ghost for our homes to be a wreck.
Yes.
We have too much power and too much anointing for our situation not to change.
Oh, man. That's right.
We got too much power in the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
For our lives to be in shambles. I know everybody say, but we're supposed to suffer. Not like that.
Amen.
We're not supposed to suffer like this. We're not supposed to suffer to the point that we can't pay our bills. We're not to be suffering to the point that we don't have and we have all this life. We're not supposed to suffer in this manner.
Not like that.
So I began to pray and ask God. I said, so what's wrong? Why do so many of us Christians lack so much? And we're so powerful. We're supposed to be so anointed, God. We're supposed to be preaching and teaching your word, ambassadors, doing your will. But we have too much lack. He said, because sin has dominion over my people.
Yes, God.
Me and my wife were talking, praise God, in reference to marriage. And, and if you ever notice, praise God, there's a lot of cheating going on in marriages.
Really?
Yeah. And my wife came out and said that, you know, Adam never cheated on his wife. You know, it makes men that aren't cheating or aren't even have that thought in their mind make us look bad, because Adam never cheated on his wife. He let his wife loose and let her go on and not pay her no mind. That's why Satan was able to do what he was able to do, the sin to step in, okay? But he never cheated on his wife.
Wow, something to think about.
Yeah, amen. Something to think about. And because what happens is that I'll preach and teach that one another time. Amen. But when you allow sin to have dominion over your life, this is the attributes of sin in your life. You have lack in the church because you have lack in your home.
Yeah.
Woo! Jesus. One of the main reasons why sin has so much dominion over you is because you have chosen the wrong God to serve.
Amen.
And I'm going to say it again. You've chosen the wrong God to serve. The Bible says that you can't serve two masters. Meaning that you have to pick. Help me, Holy Ghost. You have to pick who you want to serve. When they were slaves in the olden days, when they were slaves, praise God, the slaves couldn't pick who they was going to serve, but they were picked. Y'all see that? They were picked, and they had to answer to the slave master. I'm going to read on in the Word of God, in verse 15, Romans 6 and 15, it says, what then? Shall we sin because we are not under the law but under grace? But God forbid. Know ye not that whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey? Y'all see that?
Yeah.
Who you obey is who you're going to serve. That's in verse 16, Romans 6:16. Who you obey is who you're going to serve. At one time, you were a slave to sin. My sister spoke about this earlier. You were a slave to sin. You're supposed to be a slave to the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
But because of sin having dominion over you, you are still a slave unto sin. Because sin has dominion over you. I know you keep saying, preacher, why do you keep saying sin has dominion? Because you haven't chose which God to serve. You got the wrong shoes on. You put on the wrong jacket. You said the wrong thing out your mouth when you said to yourself that I refuse to serve God. When God, when you were sitting in that bar stool, when you were sitting in that home, when you were doing what you were doing in the world, and God knocked on your heart, and you chose to keep your door closed, you chose which God you wanted to serve. Right then and there, you wanted to serve the enemy. You wanted to be right there with Satan holding his hand. I'm gonna go on. Verse 17. It says, but thank be God that ye were servants of sin, but ye have obeyed from the heart that from the doctrine which was delivered unto you. This meaning real, real short and simple, put it to you this way, is that you obeyed from your heart what God had already put in it. It was a seed that was dropped in your soul. Seed that was dropped in your heart that made you transform parts.
Come on.
Something hasn't been done. How was you able, praise God, to change partners without a seed being planted? This is why sin has so much demand over you, because you chose not to obey or look at the seed which was planted. See, we had too much problems, and when we had too many situations where we're focused on our situation against someone who can already fix the situation. See, we're always looking for man to fix something only God can fix.
Only God can do it.
So when it comes to sin, only God can heal your sin. Only God can fix your sin. Only God can fix your addiction. Only God can fix what you've been holding on to, what you need to be delivered from. Only God can transform that out of your soul. So stop talking to your neighbor. For the Bible says that, what are you talking to the unsaved about your problems? You're saved. We can't go to the unsaved talking about, I need some help. You're supposed to be able to go to the saved and tell them you need some help. But because of sin, I'm going back to the root of this, but because of sin, we are unable to be transparent one to another. This morning, the Bible study, we talk about serving one another. This is part of serving one another, being transparent. If I can't be transparent with my brother or my sister, according to the word of God, then I can't be transparent with anyone. So I'm going to still have the lack in my life. I'm still going to have lack in my life, which ultimately is going to end up me still having the sin that I was dealing with in my life. How many of us can actually get over something by ourselves? You can't do it. You can't quit smoking by yourself. You just can't do it. You can't get away from alcohol by yourself. You just can't do it. No, I don't care what addiction is out here. You can't get over it by yourself. You still need somebody to help you get over that through the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Verse 18, it says, being then made free from sin, ye became the servants of righteousness. I want to repeat that. Being then made free. When you accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you was made free.
Free. Okay.
When you chose the right God to serve, you became free. And what I mean by the right God, I mean by the Lord Jesus Christ. So you can go ahead and keep calling your money your God. You can go ahead and keep calling your home your God. You can go ahead and idolize those things that you hold so dear. But those things that you idolize will not get you into heaven.
Amen.
I want to help somebody get into heaven this morning. So I'm going to go on just a little bit here, praise God. The Bible says, praise God,
being made free. I love that part. Because you don't want to be bound to no dumb stuff. You don't want to be bound to the enemy. All my young people here, listen to this here. The longer that you choose not to serve God, is the longer you're going to go through the servitude of torture of your life. I'm going to make
that a little bit plain. I'm going to make it a little plain.
The longer you choose not to serve God and to stay in your sin, the Bible says the wages of it is death. The longer that you stay in your sin, the farther away you get from God. It's time for you to put aside our childish ways. Watch this. I'm going to preach this. I'm going to help y'all to pray. Need y'all to pray for me. The reason that some folks can't stop talking about some people is because they're still acting like the child that they was. For the Bible says, when I was a child, I did some childish things. Y'all know what y'all did when you was a child. As soon as you became an adult, you didn't put away childish things, but you carried it into your adulthood. So now you got to do the same thing. You got to make somebody feel bad. You got to make somebody feel lower than you because you feel low. You just got to do something to hurt somebody's feelings. You got to do that. Why? Because it makes you feel good because you chose to have let sin have dominion over you. I'm going to preach that one. I'm going to say it again. The main reason that's why some folks had that struggle about talking with somebody is because they're still doing the childish things.
Yeah.
Adults, we don't talk about each other. What do adults do? We come together, praise God. We try to commune with one another. We try to work some things out. But what do children do? Children talk about one another. Then they end up fighting. Y'all don't want to hear me in this place. I know I'm stepping on somebody's toes, but it's all right. I'm not scared, praise God. But I want you to know and understand, as long as you keep doing what you're doing, being in the sin that you're in, you're letting sin have dominion, having rule over you. Which means that you're still the slave to sin that you thought you were delivered from. You're still enslaved.
Still enslaved.
You're still getting bit by the slave master if you didn't know that. You're still getting burnt and abused. You're still getting scratched left because you didn't obey the slave master. I know y'all don't want to obey me in this place and really obey what this is saying, but I want to let you know this morning that in order for you to come from up under that slave master, you need to lift your hands up and start giving God some praise and some hardships in this place. I understand, praise God, that the pews aren't filled as of yet. See, this is what y'all scared of. Y'all scared of people coming in here. Woo! Hallelujah. Y'all scared for folks to come up in here. And I'm going to tell you why you're scared. Because they're going to see the real you. Woo! You don't want nobody to see you. You don't want nobody to see you for the devil that you are. You don't want nobody to see you, praise God, touch and agree, and you still lying. Y'all don't want to hear me in this place. Hallelujah. I'm going to go on to verse 18. It says, being made free. I don't know about you, but there's a way to be made free, praise God. And I'm going to teach this to you real quickly. The Bible says that when you become baptized, you go down in the water, you become a new creature. So how do you become, not that sin have dominion over you, is that you have to become a new creature. But y'all don't want to be new creatures. Y'all want to be the same creature y'all was last week. That's why you can't get your shout on. That's why you can't get your praise on. That's why you can't get your breakthrough. Why? Because you want to be that same person that you were last Sunday, this Sunday. This is why sin has dominion. Because you don't want to change. You choose. Don't you know changing is a choice? Changing is a choice that you got to make. Jesus ain't going to make it for you. You got saved for what reason? What reason did you get saved? What reason did you wake up this morning and come to the house of God? What reason did you have to do that this morning? Were you looking for God to move, or did you just want to hear the latest news? What did you wake up to? Well, God woke us up this morning to come to the house of God for a reason. We're supposed to be uplifting hands and giving God praise. Not fighting one with another, but serving one another. Hallelujah. You're supposed to be coming to the house of God to uplift one another. Not to pull each other down. Supposedly, you got to walk us up this morning. For a purpose. For him. He didn't wake you up for yourself. He woke you up for somebody else. He woke you up for somebody else. Turn to the book of Matthew chapter 6. Book of Matthew chapter 6. Well, my alarm clock did wake me up.
Amen.
But he woke me up for a reason.
Amen.
6:24, no man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he would hold to one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and man. You can't serve God and the devil. You just can't do it. This scripture here gives you a choice. Jesus is saying, which one do you serve today? Are you going to actually be honest with yourself and says, Satan, get behind me? Or can you look yourself in the mirror and says, for God I live, for God I die. Which God are you going to serve today? When you leave here, when tomorrow comes, are you going to be able to serve God? Or are you going to serve the devil again? Are you going to be a changed person? Or are you going to be the same person you are right now? You can only serve but one God. Now, I want to tell you there are three people something.
Yes.
If you want to keep serving and idolizing those idols, God is a jealous God.
Yes, yes, yes.
Y'all think it was wrong when Sister Ruby said that somebody's going to die? God will strike you down because he's a jealous God.
Jesus.
You can't serve the devil and serve God. You can't curse the blessed out of the same mouth.
Yeah, yeah.
Go ahead
now.
He's a jealous God.
Hey!
You need to be touched. Y'all don't want to hear this word. I'm going to get to it. You need to be touched. God can touch your life and it's gone right now. Keep going. Keep living in sin. I'm going to say it like this. Keep living in that sin. Because the man is up to his death. You keep living in your sin. You don't want to choose God. God is jealous, God. Let's take you out of here. You go on and be steady in your sin. I'm going to pray for you. I'll tell Pastor Riley and I'll tell all the good y'all just pray for this person because they choose not to change. And if a person don't choose to change, there's nothing you can do with that person. For the Bible says we ought to be able to change. At any time, we ought to be changed. And it's a shame, Pastor Riley, when you can't do anything with somebody who doesn't want to change. You want to admit that you don't want to change, and yet you let sin have dominion and rule over you.
Yeah.
So when you see us up here praying that prayer, Satan, get out in the name of Jesus and go back to hell. We should see some demons running out that door.
Hell.
I know y'all didn't want to hear that, but the Bible says, "Even in the name of Jesus, demons tremble." Praise God. So there shouldn't be any demons in the sanctuary, praise God. Because in the sanctuary lies the Holy Ghost.
That's right, that's right.
I know you had a lot of them get to shout out for that one, that's all right. But in the sanctuary lies the Holy Ghost. And the Bible says, in the Spirit of the Lord, there is liberty.
Liberty.
I don't know about y'all, but I like to be free. I can't see myself behind God, praise God. I can't see myself behind God, praise God. I don't know about you, but I know the sin did to me and how much it had me locked up. I know the sin can do to a person, praise God, when they locked up in their mind. I know the sin can do to a person, praise God, when they're looking at the wall, talking to themselves. I know the sin can do to a person. The Bible says, be ye what? Ready. In season and out of season, you want to be what? Ready.
Y'all don't want to hear this. I'm going to close out in a minute.
Hey, listen, in order for the house of God to be ready, there's something that got to change in the atmosphere. The first thing that got to change in the atmosphere is that people got to be on the prayer. That's the first thing that got to change in the atmosphere, in the water cooler. But people don't want to be on the prayer. I wish I could read back that and do it open and tell you to leave. But if you don't want to get on that prayer, but that's what I'm waiting for. I'm waiting for God to have his way. I'm waiting for the whole church to go back to praising God, praise God. Not just a few people praising, but everybody praising. Everybody putting their hands together and everybody stomping their feet. God is looking for some spirit and in truth worshipers.
Yes.
But the main reason, again, why you don't worship, praise God, because you ain't got no Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost came and gone. Holy Ghost has came and gone, and then you look around and seeing what's going on. You ask God, Lord, what did I do wrong? You already know what you did wrong. You already know that you said that you had a hand in everything. And let me tell you something. If this church don't get right, praise God, I'm going to tell you something right now. When the door's closed, it's going to be your fault. I know y'all didn't like that, but I'm going to tell you the truth.
That's right.
Keep it coming.
I'm going to tell you the truth. Ooh, yeah. The book of 1 Corinthians 6 and 20 says, for we are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, word of God. I want to tell you something about this thing that sin that has dominion over some folks. You were bought with a price. The blood of Jesus bought you. Jesus did some things, praise God, that you can't do for nobody else. You can't do for no other man, and no other man can't do it for you. But Jesus did it for you. Jesus paid a price for your soul. Now, I don't know about you, but I know when you go and out and buy something, you're going to and you want to receive something back. Am I right about it? You're not going to go buy a car and leave with no car. Am I right about it? So what do you think Jesus is doing? He bought you with a price. What do you think he went on that cross for? For his health? No, he went on that cross because he was buying something. He was bringing God's people back unto him. And we got the audacity and nerve to let sin have dominion over us, and we were already bought. We were born with the blood of Jesus. We got so many problems and issues and this, that, and the other. And all the thing we got to do is give God praise. Give man a sacrifice. I know that you don't feel like holding up to God. I care if you get holding to him. Who cares? Sing the song anyhow. I know, watch this. I know that money is shot. But it doesn't mean you ain't supposed to pay your tithes. I'm going to touch that and I'm going to leave that and I'm going to keep it moving. I know money is shy. Right? But it doesn't mean you're not supposed to pay your tithes. If you get $300 a week, guess what? 10% of that $300 is what? $30. You're going to use that anywhere. You're going to use it on garbage, on junk food, whatever you're going to use it on. But pay God first. Pay God first.
All right, preacher.
All right. Give God his money.
All right, preacher. You're talking now. You're talking good.
Pastor, like that one.
Preacher. You're talking good talk.
Yeah. Amen. Pastor Riley said that the people were coming and God told me some. Many months ago, about a year and a half ago, that 300 people were supposed to come in here. Alright? And I still believe and I still know that they're going to come in here.
Amen.
The major problem that we have is that do you believe it? We can sit up here all day long and believe. We can sit up here all day long and fast and pray. But do you believe it?
Do you believe
it? We got up and formed this circle and we said prayers. But did you believe your prayer? And I'm going back to this message. Who do you obey today? Do you obey the devil or do you obey God? The Bible says that some things come through fasting and through prayer.
Yes, it does.
Fasting and through prayer. And I'm a witness of it because I know it works, praise God. So if you say out your mouth today that you believe that people are going to come in here, that means you want to fast and to pray. Watch this until you see it happen. Y'all didn't see that one, right? Y'all didn't get that one?
Yeah.
Y'all didn't get that one? And everyone who opened up their mouth and said, I'm going to say it, and said out of their mouth that they believe their prayer that people are going to come in, that means you need to fast and to pray until it happens. Watch this. Jesus told the disciples, stay right here and pray, and I'm going to go up here and pray. When he came back down, he saw the 12 disciples sleeping.
Amen.
And that's exactly what you've been doing for the last many years, sleeping. Woo! This is why you got so much fighting and discord in your church, because you got people sleeping, praise God. This is why you got so much disorder and unorganization in the church, because you got people that are sleeping. I'm ready to close this out, but I hope y'all hear me. In order to stop sin having dominion over your life, serve Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Out of everything you've ever been through in your life, I can guarantee, listen, I've been shot at. Lord, you know, I've been through a whole lot of stuff. And you know what I can say to the people that try? I'm still here. I'm still here. You know, listen. Even to tell the devil that tried to kill you at birth,
Moses' house. You can tell the devil in his face, you missed.
You missed.
The bullet didn't hit me. My body might have some pain, but I'm still here. Because the same trying to kill you, and you didn't recognize it. But since God knew your future, since God knew you had a plan for you, he held you in his hands. And he brought you out of some darkness and soon you were out of his life. He had you by his hand. Even though you was in your sin, he had his hands on you.
Yes, he did.
I'm going to go kick. Yeah. And I believe in it, it's hard to understand that.
The devil missed.
I don't know if you're catching on, getting on the right train, on the right board, but listen, the devil missed. It might be my own, it's working on my mind right now, it might be some hell, but guess what I'm going to tell you today? The devil missed. Sister Ruby, it might have been some stuff going on that you may have heard, but guess what? The devil missed. This is how the devil missed, because he's still here.
We shared that safari, you have another opportunity.
You know what? I've been looking for somebody. Not just anybody, but a special somebody. Come on. Get a prayer through. Can anybody out there pray for me without even knowing what I need? Can anybody out there pray for me? The prayers of the righteous.